All right. Today we're reading about China and the Soviet Union. Number one, was this article about? Number two, who seemed like they would be natural allies during the Cold War? Three, when did Joseph Stalin die? Four, why did Mao criticize Khrushchev? Five, what was it called as a relationship between the Chinese and Soviet Union broke down? Number six, how had the United States hoped to weaken the Soviet Union? And seven, in what year did Richard Nixon visit China? China and the Soviet Union. The Soviet Union supported the rise of Mao and the Communist Party during the Chinese Civil War. In many ways, the Soviet Union and China seemed like they would be natural allies during the Cold War. When Joseph Stalin died in 1953, Mao felt alienated by his replacement, Nikita Khrushchev. Mao objected to Khrushchev's highly publicized criticism of Stalin's policies. In 1962, Mao criticized Khrushchev's actions during the Cuban Missile Crisis. The Soviet Union leader had backed down to the United States' demands that the Soviet Union remove missiles from Cuba. Border disputes also harmed the relationship between the two countries. The gradual breakdown in relations between the two countries is often called the Sino-Soviet split. By 1970, both Mao and the President Richard Nixon saw benefits in improved relationships between the United States and China. The United States had hoped to weaken the Soviet Union's position in the Cold War by isolating it between two enemies, NATO to the west and China to the south and east. Mao helped to weaken the Soviet Union because he was concerned China was threatened by the two countries' history of border disputes. Thus, during the 1970s, China enjoyed a better economic and diplomatic relationship with the West than with the Soviet Union. United States President Richard Nixon visited China in 1972. Nixon's visit showed the international community that the United States was willing to take an important step in creating a relationship between the United States and China. During the 1970s, Western countries began to recognize the People's Republic of China. All right, go and answer those questions if you would.